of the gospel of Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believe, Jew first, and also to the Greek. So here Paul says, for I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believe, to the Jew first, and also to the Greek. Therein is the righteousness of God revealed from faith to faith, as is written, the just shall live by faith. The wrath of God is revealed from heaven against all ungodliness and unrighteousness of men, all the truth in unrighteousness, because that which may be known of God is manifest in them, for God has shown it unto them. For the invisible things of him from the creation of the world are clearly seen, being understood by the things that are made, even his eternal power of Godhead, so they are without excuse. Talking about how to be right with God. And he says here, for I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, but it's the power of God unto salvation for everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. Paul is saying that there is a way to know God. Men have traveled to the moon. They've been able to make telescopes and try to peer into the galaxies. Men have created great scientific instruments. There's one thing that man and humanity cannot do. Humanity cannot master himself. That no matter how much we advance in science and technology, no matter how much we advance in knowledge, no matter how many computers we have, no matter how great we can peer into the stars and to the galaxies, man cannot master his own heart. The heart of man cannot be mastered. We still have wars, we still have murders, we still have evil in the world. No matter how much we advance in technology, in science and knowledge, the heart of man is still the same. 10,000 years ago, man murdered, man stole, man had wars. 10,000 years later, man is still doing the same. Still murdering, still killing, still having wars. So no matter how much we advance in technology, man is always the same. The Bible says, all fall short of the glory of God. That every human being falls short of the glory of God. That the human race is fallen. The human race is broken. The human race has fallen from God and is broken. Like having a broken leg. If you have a broken leg, you've got to get it fixed. And humanity has a broken leg. Humanity is broken because humanity has fallen from its creator. And all the wars and all the things that are happening around us today come from the heart of humanity. and humanity is broken. But God wants to fix that brokenness. How do you fix the brokenness? Cry, not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. For it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For I am not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believes, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. We have wars, we have evil in the world. Men might try to patch it up with politics. The politicians come along and they try to patch it up. They try to patch up the wars. They try to patch up the evil. But politicians can't do it because man's heart will never change. So the politicians come along and they cannot solve our problems. So then we have the great philosophers, the great thinkers. They come along. And we've had our Plato and Aristotle and Hegel and Kant and Bertrand Russell and Derrida and Foucault and all the great philosophers. They come along and they try to patch up the problem. They try to patch up the problem of the evilness of the world. And the philosophers fail. The politicians fail. Then we have that great mantra, science. Science will solve it. Science will deal with it. So the scientists come along with their great brains and their great intellect and their great scientific knowledge. And they come along and they try to patch up evil. And they try to solve evil with their science. But science can be used for good or bad. All the great inventions of science are used for good and bad. Scientific invention is used to help people in hospital, but also to create nuclear weapons. So the politicians come and they try to patch up evil and they fail. The philosophers come and they try to patch up evil and they fail. The scientists come and they try to patch it up and they fail. But what about religion? Throughout the history of humanity, we have had great religious leaders. We have had Buddha, we have had Mohammed, we have had many, many great, great religious leaders. We have had Gandhi. They come along and they try to patch up evil. They try to sort out evil. And they fail. They fail. So the politicians come and they fail. The philosophers come and they fail. The scientists come and they fail. And the religious leaders come and fail. So who can sort the problem of evil out? Who can deal with the problem of evil? Who can deal with the heart of humanity? The answer is here. For I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God unto salvation to everyone that believeth, to the Jew first and also to the Greek. For I'm not ashamed of the gospel of Christ. The word gospel is good news. You see, in the midst of the evil of today, in the midst of the evil of today, God did not solve it with politics. God did not solve it with philosophy. God did not solve it with science. God did not solve it with religion. He solved it by coming down and becoming a man. He solved it by coming down and becoming a man and humiliating himself and humbling himself even to the death of the cross. And when God went to the cross, he defeated evil where politicians couldn't do it, where philosophers couldn't do it, where scientists couldn't do it, where the religious could not do it. He defeated evil by becoming nothing, by humbling himself, by dying on that cross. And when he died on that cross, that was the wisdom of God. The wisdom of man to deal with evil is to dominate, to control, to exercise power. That is the wisdom of man. The wisdom of man is to fight. The wisdom of man is to dominate. The wisdom of man is to control. But the wisdom of God was to humble himself. The wisdom of God was to hand himself over to his enemies to be whipped. The wisdom of God was that he came to die on that cross. There when he died on that cross, he defeated evil. He became nothing that you could become something. He became nothing that you may live. He became nothing and gave his life away for you. He showed his love to you and to humanity by dying for you on that cross. Not a great political answer, not a great philosophical answer, not a great scientific answer, not a great religious answer. It's called the wisdom of God. Paul calls it, we preach Christ crucified. It's a stumbling block to philosophers. It's a stumbling block to the Greeks. It's a stumbling block to the Jews. Man never worked it out. The great philosophers, if you read Bertrand Russell, never worked it out. Derrida never worked it out. Wittgenstein never worked it out. Einstein never worked it out. That God became a man and humbled himself and became nothing. And nothing but dying on the cross for you and me. That is the wisdom of God, my friend. My friend, that is the only hope for humanity today. The only hope for humanity today is Jesus Christ, the Lord, today. That is the only hope. But it also has a personal message for you. That Paul says that Jesus Christ is the power of God. He's not ashamed of the gospel of Christ, for it is the power of God. He was not ashamed of Christ, because Christ paid your debt. Christ paid your debt. You and I have a debt to God. You and I owe God. Every day we breathe his air. Every day we use all his resources. And then one day God requires of you and I to give an account. And if we gave an account, then we're going to be lost forever. There is not going to be any hope. But God has the answer for you. God did not leave you. God did not give up on you. God came and died for you. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, the Prince of Glory came down, and the Prince of Glory died and shed his blood for you on that cross. The Prince of Glory gave his all for you. He was whipped and mocked and humiliated, and the Prince of Glory laid down his life for you on that cross. When I survey the wondrous cross on which the Prince of Glory died, the Prince of Glory died for you. How many philosophers have died for you? How many scientists have died for you? How many religious leaders have died for you? But he died. He died on that cross and shed his blood for you on that cross, that you may come home to Jesus, that you may come home to heaven. He laid down his life that you may come home. And he says, come home to me. Come home to me. I loved you. Come home to me. I died for you. No philosopher ever died for you. No politician ever died for you. No scientist ever died for you. No religious leader ever died for you. But I, the Son of God, came down and was mocked and humiliated. I was whipped in the garden. I was spat at. I was humiliated. And I went through that for you. I went through that for you. I took the beating, says Jesus. I took the whipping and the humiliation. And I took it for you. I died for you. And I gave my life for you. Oh, the deep, deep love of Jesus. Vast, unmeasured, powerless, free, rolling as a mighty ocean in its fullness over me. the mighty love of God, that Christ would come and shed his blood and give his life for you. Oh, what a love so deep, so vast. Oh, what a love so great and mighty. God came down and became nothing to rescue you and bring you home. Nothing in all the universe, nothing in your life is greater than that message. That God came down and became a man and died on that cross that you may live. My friend, there is a hope for you tonight. There is a joy that you can have tonight. There is a peace that you can have tonight. There is a love of God that you can have tonight. You can know God tonight. You can have love in your heart tonight. You can know the peace of God and the love of God. All because of Jesus. All because of him. Nelson was a great man. Churchill was a great man. But there was no greater man than Jesus. There was no greater man than him. The Son of God came down and he loved you and gave himself for you. It was the greatest act in history. Nelson did a great thing. Nelson saved our ships. Churchill did a great thing. He saved our nation. But Jesus did a greater thing. He saved you on that cross. He saved you on that cross. That was the great act of God for you. The great act of God was that he died on that cross. My friend, trust him today. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. He said, I am the light of the world. He said, I am the bread of life. The love of God, the love of Jesus, he said, I am the light of the world. He said, I am the bread of life. He said, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No one can come to the Father but through me. He says, I am the way. Not the politicians, not the scientists, not the philosophers, not the religious leaders. He says, I am the way. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. That is the way to heaven, Jesus. That is the way to knowledge, Jesus. That is the way to salvation, Jesus. He says, I am the light of the world. The light shines in the darkness. The light shines in a dark place. But you can get that light in your life. You can allow the light of Christ to shine in your life by having faith in him and trusting in him as your Lord and Savior and allowing the light of God to come in. Allowing the light of God to shine in your life. And I am the bread of life. You need bread. Sustain yourself. You've got a soul. You've got a soul that needs to be sustained by God. I am the bread of life. Says I am the bread of life. Says I am the way, the truth, and the life. He is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the one to know joy. He is the one to know peace. He is the one to know love. He is the one to look to. He is the one to believe in. He is the one, Jesus Christ the Messiah. Jesus Christ the Savior. He is the one to look to, my friend. In the midst of the pain, in the midst of the problems, in the midst of the darkness, Jesus is the one to look to. To look to. Jesus Christ is the one to look to. He is the one with the light. He is the one with the hope. He is the one with the joy. He is the one with the peace. He is the one with the love. He gave himself and died on that cross. He is the one that you need tonight. What are you searching for? What are you looking for? There is a greater purpose in your life that God has, and that is to look to the light. Look to him. I am the light of the world, he says. He says, I am the way, the truth, and the life. And it's looking to him and trusting him. Psalm 23 says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. The Lord is my shepherd. Drugs ain't my shepherd. Alcohol ain't my shepherd. Sex ain't my shepherd. Money ain't my shepherd. My career ain't my shepherd. My wife ain't my shepherd. Jesus is my shepherd. The Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He doesn't say, porn is my shepherd. Drugs is my shepherd. Alcohol is my shepherd. No, he says, the Lord is my shepherd. I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pasture. Christ is the one that died for you. Christ is the one that laid down his life for you. Your drug dealer did not die for you. Did your drug dealer die for you? Did your drug dealer die for you? Did your drug dealer die for you? Did the lottery tickets die for you? Did the lottery ticket sellers die for you? No. Did the government die for you? No. He died for you. He died for you. He died for you. He died for you. He laid down his life for you. When I said, I wonder which the Prince of Glory died. My friend, he laid down his life for you, shed his blood for you, and he loved you, and he died for you, my friend. He loved you and died for you on that cross. He loved you and died for you on that cross. Not just the name of this. So what will you do? Will you believe in him? Are you going to believe in great news? Are you going to believe in great news of all time? The good news of Jesus. The good news of the Lord. He loved you and died for you on that cross. He loved you. There is power, power. Oh, let it shine. let it shine. Loved you, folks. Died for you on that cross. Come home. Come home. Come home. We want you to come home. Come home to Jesus. Come home, America. Come home. Come to Africa. Come home, my country. Come home. We want you to come home. We love you. Come home to Jesus. Come home to Him. He's waiting for you. Come home. Come home. Come home. He loves you. He loves you. Come home. He's waiting for you. Come home to Him. Come home to Jesus. Come home to Jesus. Come home to Him. He's waiting for you right now. Come. Bring your burden. Bring your burden. Come. Come weeping. Come crying. Come burden. Come. Come home, and He'll carry your burden. Come home, and He'll help you. Come home, and He'll forgive you. Come home, and He'll praise you. Come home to Jesus. Come home, He loves you tonight. Come home, He forgives you tonight. Come home, He praises you tonight. He shows you His love tonight. He praises you tonight. Come home to Him. Come home to the Lord today, and know His love. Come home, He loves you, and died for you. Come home to Jesus and know His love in your life. God bless you.